Tonight, from Gillette Stadium in Foxborough, it's a special primetime edition of the NFL on EA Sports.
It's a rematch of the 2004 Super Bowl. The Pats and Panthers are underway. This is taken just shy of the 10. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line. Now here comes Teddy Bridgewater, first-round pick back in 2014 as he looks to command this Panther offense.
And I liked what his head coach told us about him this week, that no matter what happens, whether he throws seven interceptions or seven touchdown passes, he's the same assertive leader in the huddle on each and every play. He can throw the seven interceptions, just blame the football, blame anything else.
And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Christian McCaffrey, 75 yards. And the Panthers are going to take a first quarter lead. Christian McCaffrey, a guy that can beat you in so many ways. He's a threat to go the distance literally every time he touches the football.
I think defensively, when you look at a play like that, that's when everyone looks at their teammates and starts shaking their heads a little bit, because now you're wondering, what are we in for? Worked all week to try and limit the big play ability that he possesses, and he winds up taking one to the house in the very first quarter. That was a tremendous run.
And he covered a lot of ground on that one, as evidenced by the final total there on Next Gen Stats. So here come the Patriots to take over on offense. They'll be led out by their quarterback at 6'2 out of Auburn. It's Jarrett Stidham. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
They'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. 26 big yards on that one. It's another first down. The former seventh-round pick, Julian Edelman, just continues to have such a productive career.
And has made himself into a receiver. Remember, he was a college quarterback, and not just a productive one, a very good one.
The Kent State, right?
Yes, a great leader, a guy who could make plays with his feet and his arm. Got to the NFL and had to convert into being a receiver and was drafted that way. And that conversion, oh boy, it's been good.
Powerful running. And he can't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. Gain of 15 gets him on the doorstep, first and goal.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here.
And he is in. Touchdown.
Let's go.
Punching it in from a yard away. And the Patriots are within an extra point of tying this one up. A strong, determined run there, Charles, to get in for 6 points.
This is why it's such a team game, isn't it? I know it sounds really generic, and it sounds almost trite, but the blocks were made up for our offensive line, collective victory at the line of scrimmage and downfield, and how about the finish to the run all the way into the end zone?
Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. An incredibly short kick, feeling way up there. And solid field position here to start as they get this out to the 40-yard line.
In a tie game, both sides are looking for something to give them an advantage. It often falls back on special teams. And that return, that could be the spark to untie the game.
They start on the ground with McCaffrey. The ball's out. McCaffrey wants it. And it's picked up by the Patriots. And they'll take over inside the 45 at the 44-yard line. There are two words that we hear coaches say all of the time. One starts with a B, one starts with an S. Ball security.
And they preach it. They have it up in the meeting.
The fumble on first down. Now here's second down. From the shotgun, it's Bridgewater. And it's incomplete. Robbie Anderson, the man he was looking for. And it's third and five.
A lot of times, just that first read that you have, maybe you get it in pre-snap. He locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and now it's incomplete.
And he goes down. It's a Patriot sack. Dietrich Wise in there to get him for a loss of 9 yards, and that also leads to fourth down. Boy, he came in off the edge so quickly there.
Look out, because that's exactly what it was being shouted by the offensive lineman to his quarterback, because he had no chance to block him.
A big kick there. We'll call it 56 yards on the punt. And the Pats will be backed up deep to get the drive started as they take over first and 10. So back onto the field come the Pats for their second drive, and they will start this drive with just terrible field position, backed up inside their own five.
But we have seen teams be bold here and take shots, right? Sometimes you need max protection, make it a one receiver route, and take your shot downfield and see what happens. And occasionally, we've seen success occur.
So that flag will cost them 15.
And it doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask. Any part of it, that's going to be 15 yards.
On the move to his left. And he'll pull it down. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
It's second down there.
From the gun, Moore. And that'll be incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he was going. But surprise, that guy was covered. That took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
To throw on third down. Moore. He'll have it first down past the 40. And he will have the Patriots first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. 18 big yards on that one. And a New England first down. Operating from the gun. Moore. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete. The free safety, Trent Boston, there to knock it away. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. He's going to look deep for Edelman. It's caught inside the 25. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. An excellent gain, 35 yards.
That is the exact right play call against that defense. So a hat tip to the offensive play call, because he won that part of the chess match. And give credit to his players as well. They won the execution part of it.
And the Patriots are going to have a first and goal forthcoming as he takes this down to about the 5-yard line. These two teams all tied after one. trying to pound it in here with Michelle. And taking it in the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Sony Michelle with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Patriots have taken the lead. Now, always a good first half when you can hit pay dirt twice.
And it never hurts to have that good feeling as the game moves on. Just think about halftime. If that's all he gets, he'll just sit there at the half and think, all right, two already. I can get some more. I can get some more. And he'll be encouraging his offensive line to create some space.
So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. This one taken just inside the 10. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
The Panthers take over first and 10.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. The drive begins with a run by McCaffrey. And that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Bridgewater going to give this to McCaffrey. And he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of 3. And guess what? It brings up third down.
Sometimes your losses get challenged. At times you don't want them to. They did try to stick to the running game on the first two plays. Didn't amount to much.
And now facing a third and long at the outset of this drive. He's out, he can't get rid of the football, and it's taken down. Lawrence Guy coming in to drop him for a loss of 8, and it also brings up 4th. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Yeah, and that's just so difficult for them because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA at power forward. It's really a difficult task.
Moore throwing on first down. Over the middle, Julian Edelman, it's complete. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he get a good head of steam going.
He's going to walk one deep left side here. And that will be incomplete. Try to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. Great way to convert on third down there. 21 yards the play. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. 2 minutes remaining in this first half for football. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando and Jonathan Coachman. We'll have highlights and analysis of this first half of action. Now a pass here caught by Edelman. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
Brings up third and 12.
Now Moore. He's going to have the hook up to Izzo. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A first down and then some. Give him 29 yards.
That's a play that will likely be forgotten when he talked about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And points result, we'll call this play significant.
This tackle a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and 1. And this is caught. It's out of there. Touchdown! A 20-yard touchdown! And the Patriots, they add on to their lead. So simple math here in the first half. They've had three drives offensively, and they have scored every time, and they've got a lead.
Well, whenever we talk about adjustments, we usually talk about an offense making adjustments, right? This is all about the defense. They've got to figure out some way, somehow, to slow them down. Do they blitz a little bit more? Do they play more zone coverage? Right now, they don't know where to go because they're hitting them in every direction.
And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. DJ Moore, the Carolina offense, about to take over once again.
You better believe that he's well aware he has zero catches right now, and they're losing, so he's probably a little hungry.
And you know the guys on defense are aware.
And down he goes. The pressure getting to Bridgewater.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been on constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game. Open man is Samuel, complete. So we've reached the intermission, and what right now is a 13. You want the third quarter already? No problem. Let's do it. So here we go for half number two. The Patriots with the lead, and they will be getting the football. Takes this about 5 yards deep, and this will be brought out to the 25 as Taylor elects to not return it. New England with a first down as they begin the drive. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on.
To their lead. The CD, I mean, there are touchdown runs, and then there are touchdown runs, and that one certainly fell into the latter category, and that deserves a couple exclamation points.
And this is a play defensively where you're just looking around and saying, what was that? What just happened? You're looking at your teammates, they're looking at you, and let's face it, your defensive coordinator, he's not going to tip his cap to him. That's not how football works, but he probably should have after that run. That was absolutely sensational.
And he covered a lot of ground on that one, as evidenced by the final total there on Next Gen Stats.